Hi girls, I'm going to show you how to do Sharpie art. First of all, I've got my Sharpies. You can buy from Builders Warehouse or any stationery store, but apparently Builders Warehouse are the cheapest with the Sharpies. So I've got blue, green, yellow, orange and pink here. I'm going to show you how to do some embossing too. So I've got embossing foil here and then I've got my UV glaze. I just want to tell you that when you do Sharpie art, please do not use the other top coats because it makes the cokey run more. And then I've got black gel liner, white gel liner and sanitizer, and I've got a dapple dish with you can use either sanitizer or finishing wipe, so long it's an alcohol based product. You can even dip into the vodka bottle if you want to. And now and then take a sip from your dapple dish. Okay, I've prepared ourselves a nail here. It's a competition stiletto. I've used number 77 of the gel polish range from Planet Nails. So I've already prepared it. It's got a UV glaze on. You've got to glaze it because you need the smooth finish to glaze on top. Okay, so I'm just going to put this to one side. That, and that. And now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to do random colors. So I first want to open up these cokies because the lids are quite tight. Okay, so now I'm going to start. Let's do something blue in this corner. And let's do a pink center with orange around it. It'll look like a childish scribble pattern that you are making, but the end result will be very beautiful. And I'm going to give that also an orange insert. And let's do a blue with a pink around it. You can sort of make little circles around it. I'm going to do a pink with yellow, and let's do an orange right here at the bottom with yellow. Then I'm going to do a few dashes green. So this looks like a little Great Oz drawing that he will make for his mommy. But now after finishing it off, it's going to look beautiful. I just want to recap these markers quickly. Okay. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to take this. I'm going to use my brushes. And for this instance, I'll use the medium length brush. You've got to have a piece of paper ready, your alcohol, then you dip your brush in the alcohol, dab it dry, just want to move it to this side, just dab it dry slightly, then you put it down and you will see the colors will start to run. Actually move the colors around too. Okay, now let's start on this one. Start in the center, do like a rolling motion with it. Just dry it and then I'm gonna start spreading it outwards. With Sharpie art, it's quite unpredictable what's going to happen with the colors. And we're going to start on this one. Boom. Now what's amazing about the Sharpie art is I can always, when the alcohol is dry, I can go back and I can redo some of the things with my cookies. So you can add, oh, that's too much. You can wipe off some of the color too if you think it's too much. That one is already dry, and I want some more of the orange in there. So I can go and I can just draw some more orange in there. Now, very lightly, just a bit. And there you go. Now, this must dry quickly. Then I'm going to quickly cut this with the UV gloves. Just wait. Oh, we still need to do the green. The green. Let's quickly do the green. You can do such marvelous things with your Sharpies. I can see all the flowers that I'm going to, we are going to highlight them, because we're going to use the black lilac gel to highlight them, and then I'm going to emboss it. So just waiting for that last bit of alcohol to dry off. Okay, so now I'm going to use my UV gloves. Just quickly glaze it over. Because if you make a mistake with your gel, you can quickly just wipe it off. But if it's directly on the cookie, aren't you going to mess it up? So just quickly going to glaze this. So for 30 seconds, and I'll add the pro clay lab. This is really nice art to do, and because the Sharpie art, when you put alcohol over it, it's a very unpredictable kind of art, but that's what makes it so special, is that you can do then wondrous things with whatever patterns came out. Okay, so there it's been glazed, Now I can start with the rest of the art. Okay, I'm going to use black. Okay, now I want to show you girls how to load your brush. For that, I'm going to need a piece of tin foil. I'm going to show you how to load a brush. So I'm going to dip my brush into the gel, up to the hilt. Scrape it off next to the sides and dip the tip into it. Then you draw lines over your piece of tin foil until you feel you can do a fine line. Okay, so now, what I'm going to do here, let's start with that one. Make the outside of the flower. Your first flower. There's nothing but a little like our Susie flower. So it's all about your imagination when you do this kind of art and want to do flowers. The outside edges. I'm just going to quickly put it in. Okay. Let's do like an iris top. This flower, you can actually see like a tulip colored flower. Sweet chickpea, fragrant sweet chickpeas. I'm going to use another brush. So I'm going to use some fine detail in here. This one. found all the flowers. Oops, I touched the idiot me. I'm going to do the leaves in white. I'm going to detail them in white. Now I'm going to cure this quickly for 60 seconds in the oven. And the teagle in this company is just not up to scratch today. The photographer is dying, I am dying, and no coffee. That's my very irritating Yorkie in the background. Okay, so that has been cured now. Now I'm going to show you. You all asked, how do they do the gold under the photos? Now I'm going to show you how they do it. So I've got gold transfer foil. Now what I do is, I take a piece and I press it onto my black lines and I pull it away. And I press it onto those, go a little bit, and pull it away. And immediately the transfer shows. So let's do it there. Bottom. You always go over if you feel it's not completely sufficiently covered like you would want it to be covered. Got to press down quite a bit for the foils to stick. And my pencil is losing its nail. So I'm going to just press it back on again. Okay. Now, alcohol or anything else will destroy your embossing. So I'm going to cut this quickly again and cure it for 30 seconds. Because I don't want to lose any of the work that I've done now. So if you're scared you're going to lose some of your work with your next step, rather just glaze or top coat it and then cure it and carry on then. So, quickly going to pop this into the lamp. 30 seconds and I'm going to get, we're going to do some mixed art. I'm going to get like a gel polish. Because there's no room telling you not to mix arts. So we're going to mix a bit of arts here. So I've taken out two green colors. It's the Pantone colors of the year, green. So I've got a very nice mint green and I've got a very nice apple green. It's like a toxic apple green color, which I'm going to use in our nail art. If you wanted to know the number, it's number 026. And number 089. Okay, so what I'm going to do in meanwhile, I'm going to clean off my brush that I'm going to use now in the finishing work. Okay. Now, this is done. We're going to start doing detail on the leaves. So I'm going to use some of this mint green and some of this really nice apple green. This is what I'm going to do now. I'm going to do the outline. Make like a hard shaped leaf. know those beautiful heart-shaped leaves that you get. That's what we're going to do here now. Then, you just play around, make it fun for yourself. Art doesn't have to be rigid. Art is fun. There's no rules about a leaf must look like this or a flower must look like this. It's how you perceive art. You don't have to make it look like a realistic flowers and realistic. This is art and this is fun. So you do with it what you want to do with it and you enjoy it. Because art mustn't be a problem, it must be fun doing art. And I love doing art. Art is fun. Here I've put some lines into the big leaf. Let's drop off this. I really want you girls to enjoy art because art is such a nice thing. You mustn't be, oh, this client is coming and I can't do the art that she wants. Tell her, you know what, I haven't done this before, but let's give it a go. And try it. The client will anyways be so surprised if you can get very close to what she wanted. So just enjoy it. Don't feel pressured or anything. Just adding small bits of bobs and ends. I'm going to first cure the leaves and then I'm going to show you what I'm going to do with the white gel liner. And you know what? With practice comes perfect. Okay. So now I'm going to cure that. Oops. For 60 seconds in the Pro Glow UV and UV line. So, okay, it should be almost finished curing there. Okay, cool. Now, I'm going to use a dotting tool. And I'm going to put some dots down. You can go in between black and white dots. It just adds a bit of depth to your flower. Just small details. You don't need to be major details, small details. Thank you. And I just see people around me involved with new technology. I love you, peoples. I will continue to make all kinds of educational videos with, in regards with art, and later with also some technical details like doing a reverse French to show you girls how easy it is to reverse French. But for today, we've made quite a few videos which I will upload in the next couple of days. So now I've finished curing, and now I'm just going to glaze it in. And I've got a very special dog inside the salon. We're always here to entertain the guests in the salon. And the poor cat was mauled by a dog, but he's on his way to recovery. So we're just waiting for that nail to cure. And it's done. And that is my flower fantasy created with Sharpie Art, gel liner, golden transfer foil, and some gel polish. Just look at that flower there, or that leaf there. There's so many things that you can do with so many products that's all around you. You must just look. I mean, you can even encapsulate flowers, bugs, spiders. Please don't let anyone come to me with now spiders or dead spiders for that fact. But there's so many things that you can do with nails. There is just no limits to it. Thank you. I hope you find this very interesting. Until we see you again. Cheerios.